A very good morning to all the excellences, distinguished guests, my respected teachers, team members, and all the enthusiastic contestants. I am Nitya, and today I am going to conduct this WVS6 Beautifully event, which is based on a book review and a movie review. And I must add that TPSL is trying its best to let maximum participants excel their speaking skills by varied techniques. And as it is a ritual that we can't start any of our event without blessings from our Ma Saraswati. Thank you so much, Dikshu. I cordially invite our chief guest, Dr. Vinod, librarian from Guru Jambeshwar University of Science and Technology, Hisar, and along with our honorable judges, Dr. Nisha from HAU department, HAU, Haryana Agriculture University, Hisar, Shri Sanjay Singh, TPO, Guru Jambeshwar University of Science and Technology, Hisar, Dr. Vivek Gupta, Assistant Professor from Physics Department.
Laptop. You are muting.
And Ms. Reena Yadav from SciComm Courts, Gurgaon. Please give them a big round of applause. Okay, without wasting our much time, let me introduce you all the rules of our today's event. Your location should be noiseless. And a headset is recommended.
In this audio, I'm not getting voice properly.
Participants are requested to wear decent clothes. You are allowed to speak in either in standing position or in sitting position that seems comfortable to you, but standing posture is recommended. You will be provided 100 marks. There are four criteria, 25 marks for each. That includes content quality, content delivery, power of expression, and body language. You must clearly notice it out if you are audible or visible to us or not. And now, I would request our director, training and placement cell, Mr. Pratap sir, to please speak up a few lines.
Thank you, Nitya. So after Saraswati Vandana, it's my humble duty to greet our today's guests. So first of all, on behalf of Training and Placement Cell, I would like to greet our today's chief guest, Dr. Vinod Kumar ji, who is our librarian of Dr. Ambedkar library of our Guru Jambeshwar University of Science and Technology, Hisar. And Dr. Vinoji is a very learned person, very nice personality, and today we will hear him as a chief guest of today's function. In capacity of judges, today we have brought very eminent personalities as judges. So as you know that we are conducting this program in two parts. In main room, we are having two judges. One of them is Ms. Reena Yadav. Ms. Reena Yadav ji is having 15 plus years experience of industry. Currently, she is working as GM Sales and Marketing in Saicom Codes Flexoprints Private Limited. And along with being the sales and marketing manager, she is also a good writer. She has written a very nice book, Man Mein Uthi Umange Tarange. This book was published in 2017 and was inaugurated by Mr. Yashpal Sharma, a very famous actor, in Delhi International Film Festival. Ms. Reena Yadav has come to our university as a recruiter also. She has picked a number of students from our Guru Jambeshwar University. And our second judge is Mr. Sanjay Singh ji, who is also a very learned personality, and he is working as TPO in Guru Jambeshwar University of Science and Technology, Hisar. And in second group, the group which is basically of all the winners of all competitions held till date. Because today is our sixth weekly virtual speakathon event. Before that, we have conducted five such events. So all the winners of those five events are basically competing today in a separate room. So in that room, we are having again a very important personalities as judges. We are having with us Dr. Nisha. Dr. Nisha is working as an executive in ABIC, which is Agri Business Incubation Center of HAU Hisar. She also worked as HR in a company one year back. She was working as HR. So she is also having good experience of industry. And second judge is Dr. Vivek Gupta, who is working as assistant professor in physics department in our university itself. So I welcome all the four judges and Dr. Vinod Kumarji, our chief guest of today's event. So dear students, you know that recently NIRF has released some ranking, and we are very glad to inform that our university has stood at 95th position. There are, I think, more than 400 universities in the entire country. So this position is considered as good position. And one component of this ranking is graduate outcome. What is graduate outcome? That what is the quality of all the students which are graduating from our university. So such type of event which we are conducting today, through these types of events, our students become more vocal, their personality is groomed, they are more well versed in communicating. So by conducting this type of event, we will basically increase our this graduate outcomes score. So without taking much time, in today's event of book and review contest, I welcome all the students, all the participants also, who have come forward to participate in this event. Because for participating in this event, it was required that you must have read some good book or you have analyzed that book. So you have done all these exercises. So I congratulate to all of you that you have participated in this event. Again, I welcome all the guests of today's event. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. And I am aware that our chief guest, Dr. Vinod, is ready with his blessings and wishes. So I request him to please unmute himself and guide our contestants and team members.
Good morning to all of you. It gives me immense pleasure to be the part of this contest on book and movie review. Thank you, Pratap Malik ji. Are you listening me?
Yes, you are okay. Audible.
Okay. Our training and placement cell is touching the new heights under the dynamic leadership of Pratap Malik ji and his team. apart from placement, this department is now grooming our students and making them ready to meet the market challenges. They are providing a platform to the students to enrich their proficiencies and overall personality development. Organizing such events is a part of their program. Now, you know, books play a very important role in our life. Why books are there in our life? Actually, men has a tendency to preserve their past for future. Since all human knowledge cannot be stored in human minds, as the men are mortal, so the information they are containing in their minds will go with their death. So it is now recorded in the form of books, journals, movies, songs, and more so in various formats, printed or digital. Actually, when you are reading a book, you are reading the mind of its creator. Likewise, when you are watching a movie, you are watching the skills and the other important work of the person responsible to make that movie. As an abstract can help the researchers to decide whether a particular article is of their interest or not. Likewise, a good review can make the readers aware that, or make them able to decide whether a particular book is to be read or the particular movie they would like to watch or not. Actually, these reviews also help the creators, authors, or the filmmakers to improve their writings and movies to come in future. You cannot say that people are saying that you cannot make money out of this profession. But actually, we can see that many bloggers and the book reviewers or movie reviewers, they are coming forward and putting their views after just the release of the movie or the book. The people can judge whether promoters are paying now such people. So we should know the main characteristics of a good review. That should be, it should be unprejudiced or unbiased. This should be very clear in the mind of reviewer that they should not be biased to anyone, nor to the readers or to the authors. And it should, the review should be exhaustive, means it should cover almost all the aspects mentioned in the book. But at the same time, it should be very brief and specific. People do not have to read long reviews like chapters. So be specific while making the reviews. And it should highlight the strong and weak points of the book or movie. And finally, reviewers should give their opinion over it. Is it interesting to watch that particular movie? Was it good? What actually they recommend? So it's a very beautiful event. I wish you a very big success in the coming contest also. Pratap Malik is doing very good for the department and so as to for the university. I wish him all the success. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. As you have mentioned that reading a book, let us read the mind of the writer. I can easily conclude that why psychologists and philosophers keep on reading books and books. Thank you so much, sir. And as it was clearly noticed to you all that there will be two different competitions between winners and between other contestants. So I request you all to please join the breakout room along with the judges, Dr. Nisha ma'am and Dr. Vivek sir. Please accompany them to the breakout room.
Nitya, you can start.
Okay, sir. तुम्हारा रिजल्ट डिसाइड नहीं करता तुम लूजर हो या नहीं, तुम्हारी कोशिश डिसाइड करती है. आप सभी ने ये सुना होगा, तुम्हारा रिजल्ट डिसाइड नहीं करता तुम लूजर हो या नहीं, तुम्हारी कोशिश डिसाइड करती है. और मेरा बोलना डिसाइड नहीं करता ये मूवी है या बुक, इसका डायलॉग डिसाइड करता है. सो आई वेलकम ब्रिजेश टू कम अलोंग हिज मूवी रिव्यू. द मूवी इज छिछोरे. ब्रिजेश प्लीज अनम्यूट योर सेल्फ, टर्न योर वीडियो ऑन.
Hello
Brijesh, you are audible and visible both. Continue please.
A very good noon to respected judges and my dear audience. Today I am going to review the movie Chichore. Chichore was released on 6th of September 2019 with a very low budget of 50 crores, but it done amazingly on the box office by collecting 250 crores. And talking about this movie provides a very good message to all the youth who are just being depressed due to their exams or many stress levels due to uneconomic conditions, and due to many reasons they are not compatible with that and tried a new thing which is not suitable for all, which is not good, which is very dangerous and very, very risky and very, very bad for the youth. That is suicide. First of all, we have to know why suicide comes. This suicide will come when we are depressed. When we are depressed, when we are got frustrated. When we are got frustrated, we are got frustrated when we could not get the results what we are thinking. Thinking about this Chichore, there was a dialogue that your result doesn't decide you are a loser. Your efforts decide you are a loser or a winner. We should, thinking about that, that we should try our best, not depending upon the results. Also, as we all know, that stress level can be high, but we can minimize it by using very good messages. Also in Chichore movie, as we all seen, that the boy who has failed and he tried suicide, then the his father Sushant Singh memorized her own college life and tell his student that you are not a loser, but you are a winner if you tried your best. Also, in this movie, there is a very good message that we should focus on our goal, not thinking about the results. In this movie, Chichore, there are so many topics other discussed, but it may be seems like vulgar by talking like that name, but it is not a very bad movie. It is a very entertaining movie. We can watch it out with our friends, with families, and I must recommend that all one should know, and first for once they should have to watch the movie. And till then, this is my review on movie Chichore. Thank you, and stay safe, stay home. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Brijesh. We will surely watch the movie. And as everyone know that we all are our own teachers in the school of our life. Has everyone listened this? We all are our own teachers in the school of life. So I welcome Shraddha to have a movie review over the movie Dear Zindagi. I am not good at mimicry. I am only trying to speak up the dialogues and let you all have a hint of the movie or the book. So Shraddha, please unmute yourself. Turn your video on.
I am not able to. Okay. Then.
You are audible and visible both.
Thanks for gifting us a movie, a story that tells that the journey is more important than the destination. One needs courage to make an intrusive movie on young individuals' internal complications and their lifestyles, and include us in their expedition. Eventually, therapeutic route engulfs us to the their lives, and let the extent to start the quest for happiness, and they engulfs us to an extent that we start our quest for happiness within our imperfection existence, and therein lies your success, your ability to make, to convey the message. Some simple thought and with deep statements about life, and hats off to the writer Gauri Shinde. If you don't take the steering wheel of the life into our own hands, then someone else will be your on the driver's seat. This is one of my favorite dialogues from movie Dear Zindagi, which is beautifully written, delectably crafted, and superbly acted. Starring Alia Bhatt as lead and Shah Rukh Khan as her psychiatrist, Dear Zindagi is about Kiara, an aspiring cinematographer who does small projects, ads, but wants to make entire film. But in introducing sequence, Kiara's confident banter and her body language assures us that she's highly talented and knows her job well. But the movie takes the turn when she knows and she feels that she is offered a job, her dream project, not because of her talent, capabilities, rather because of a romantic relation with her co-producer. This triggers her childhood fears and her memories, and then this becomes difficult for her. Then she consults a therapist named Jahangir Khan, called as Jugs, a life mentor that can prompt any soul to sing Love You Zindagi. There are many aspects to this movie. For instance, what career does Kiara choose? Kiara chooses a career which is questioned, and even though she was highly skilled. Second, the basic plot of the movie is dealing with the mental issues. As we have seen, are real life example of Sushant Singh Rajput, who committed suicide at the age of 34 due to depression. At the age of 5, she was abandoned by her parents, which affected her future links. Also, it is a taboo in our society that to be a psychiatrist and consult a psychiatrist. Even the family members of a psychiatrist are ashamed, too ashamed to tell that his or her own child is a psychiatrist. So it is a taboo for our society. So Diya Zindagi is a therapeutic movie, which is one needs to know, one needs to stop and appreciate one's beautiful life and say, Diya Zindagi, we haven't met for a while. So I'm here to say a hi. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Shraddha. I can conclude that don't let your past ruin your future by blackmailing. Okay. So next participant with us is Monica. She is having a book review on 40 scientifically proven ways to be happier. Monica. I request Monica to please turn on her video.
Okay. Am I audible or visible?
Yes, you are audible and visible both.
Okay. Hello, everyone. I am Monica from Guru Jumbeshwar University of Science and Technology. Today, I am going to review on the book 40 Scientifically Proven Ways to Be Happier. Don't wait for the miracles or the very big changes in our life. We can still live happily even with the small little things, because the small wins have always the compound effects in our life. So I have chosen this topic because due to this lockdown situation, people are more stressed and depressed. So they have to pay more attention on their life, that how they can be more happy. So try to feel happy. Always immerse yourself in an activity voluntarily, which provides you motivation, energy, and make you more enjoyable. Spend money on your closed ones or for the act of charity. If you don't want to spend the money, then spread the kindness. If you feel lower or feel that your mood is not good, then the sad songs even can help us to remove our mood. Don't hold grudges, never. Instead, keep a journal, start writing your heart out, never complain, always be grateful, like use the words please and thank you in your conversations, always. It helps both your friends or close people and you to remain happy and make also your day happy. Also, wear comfortable clothes so that you look more confident, because when people compliment us, then we have more energy. It helps us our brain and mood both to improve and respond in a better way. Always be hydrated, because more than 97% of our body is concluded from the water. And if we drink the proper water, then it helps to improve our brain cells function properly, and we can make proper decisions so that we can live our life happily. I have chosen this topic because the writer has made all the conclusion which are based on psychology and also scientifically proved. So the thing is that people should have to pay more attention on the very, very little things, as most of us have listen about the thing that a happy life, a happy wife makes our life happy. It means keep your partners happy, the people around your close circles happy, and you should also be happy.
Thank you so much, Monica. As she has mentioned that commenting makes people happy, complimenting makes people happy. So I compliment you that you were too good. Thank you so much. Okay, let us talk about habit. Your habit is your personality is your character, and that all is vice versa. So I welcome Ankit Verma, who is going to have a book review over The Power of Habits. A book by Charles Duhigg. And I would like to invite Ankit Verma. Ankit Verma, please turn your video on. Let me tell you, it has been taught to us by motivational speaker Pankaj Asija. And for those who are unable to get me that how we are taught to us by Pankaj Asija, I would like to tell you that Training and Placement Cell is organizing weekly webinar over life skills. And the first webinar was by our motivational speaker, Pankaj Asija, who mentioned power of habits. Ankit Verma?
Ma'am,
okay. Yes, you are audible and visible. Continue, please.
Good morning, all of you. This is Ankit from Guru Jambeshwar University of Science and Technology from Printing Technology branch. Today, I'm going to give my review on the book Power of Habits, which was recently organized by Training and Placement Cell by University. It was a live webinar. So, what is Power of Habits? As you all know that what you are going to achieve in your life or aim in your future, you have to be, it should be seen in your habits in your daily life. As we all know that habits are more powerful, as it is also go with our habits and daily life routines. So basically, as we know that habits make us more realistic and good also, and for our future too. So as the recent webinar by Pankaj Asija, he told us that we should be very patient and straightforward towards our career for our aim and goals in our life. As if you want to do something or achieve in your life, first of all, you need to change your habits to make it correct or by doing something in a very good way. As we can see, something that you are doing daily or per day in your life, as for example, we can see that as you are sleeping for 8 and 6 hours per day, but you have to study for 10 to 12 hours in a day as per your daily routine, and you are unable to wake up at the right time, then you should try slowly and slowly to get rid of that bad habits to convert into a good habit. So without habits, without good habits, we are unable to achieve anything. So we should change our habits or make our habits better to make our life good and daily routines also. As habits make our character good and character makes our life good and vice versa, as the ma'am mentioned earlier in this live session. So I would like to request you all that please, what you want to achieve in your life, see, let the people see you in your daily routine and in your daily habits. It will really helpful for you to achieve what you want to do in your daily life. This book has, this book deserves a great appreciation from me and others too. Thank you. That's all about the book review. This is a very wonderful book. You all should read it with a full confidence and interest. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Habits will sustain you either you are inspired or not. Inspiration is not necessary. Good habits are necessary. If you are obeying good habits, if you are your habits are good, then you will easily sustain without any inspiration, without any motivation. So yes. Thank you so much, Ankit. The next participant with us is Kavita Garg from MBA department. She is along with her review on the book The Secret. Kavita, please turn your video on.
Now I am audible and visible.
Yes, you are audible and visible.
Very good afternoon to all the dignitaries on DICE. So first of all, thank you so much, guys, for organizing this beautiful activity. And so I'm Kavita Garg from MBA Journal Final Year. So today I'm going to review, a novel by Rhonda Byrne, The Secret. So after reading this novel and analyzing this novel, I will going to review this novel in three parts. The first part will be the main idea about this novel so that you can understand. The second part will be what I like most about this novel. And the third part will be what I dislike about this novel. So without further ado, let's get started. So now, the secret of this novel is law of attraction. So she said, according to her, you just have to ask three things. Ask, believe, and receive. You have to ask to the universe whatever you want in your life. And after that, you have to believe that you had already gained whatever you want in your life. And after belief, you will gonna receive your things in a very insignificant time. And she also said, your thoughts become your things. So for example, if you want to lose weight, don't say, I want to lose weight. Say, I want a perfect weight. And if you want to buy a car, don't say, I can't afford that. Say, I can afford that and I can buy that. So now, moving ahead, what I like most about this novel. So this novel helps you to get to know about the purpose of your life. By asking to the universe, you are asking to yourself too. And the second thing is, this novel helps you to, after reading this novel, basically, I started believing in law of attraction. And this book gives me a positive vibe. And if it gives me a positive vibe, then what's the harm in believing the law of attraction? And now, moving ahead to what I dislike about this novel. This novel exaggerates a lot, like literally, law of attraction, law of attraction, law of attraction. And she said, whatever you see in this, in your life, just see in a very positive manner. So I give you my personal example, okay? So yesterday I transferred my money to someone else with the help of Google Pay, okay? And I thought I kept my full energy in that, believing that thought that I'm gonna get a good reward. But what I get, better luck next time, banner. Okay, so law of attraction doesn't work here. But overall, guys, this is a very good novel. You just have to give it a shot. As you know, in the past few days, that depression thing is coming out. So in my opinion, this novel can help you from moving your positive negative thoughts to the positive thoughts, and also cure your mental health. So signing off from my side and give this shot. Bye bye guys. Be safe and take care of your mental health.
Your time is over. We can't allow you. Thank you so
much.
Thank you
so much. It's done.
Okay, as you have mentioned, ask, believe, and receive.
Yeah.
You can turn your mic off.
Okay.
As you have mentioned, ask, believe, and receive. I must add that this thing happened with me too. I also did this, ask, then believe, and then receive. Pate kya hua? I asked my papa to please give me a chocolate. पापा ने बोला कि शाम को देता हूँ. आई विल डेफिनेटली गिव दैट. शाम हुई, पापा ने दी नहीं चॉकलेट. ही आस्क्ड कि फ्रिजर में चेक कर, होगी चॉकलेट. मैं भाग के गई, मैंने फ्रिज ओपन किया, देखा चॉकलेट तो नहीं थी वहां, लेकिन मैंने पापा पे बिलीव किया और जैसे ही मैं बाहर आई फ्रिज चेक करके पापा ने मुझे चॉकलेट दे दी. आस्क, बिलीव एंड रिसीव. इट हैपेंड विद मी. ओके, सो नेक्स्ट पार्टिसिपेंट विद अस इज गोइंग टू हैव अ बुक रिव्यू ओवर The Story of My Life by Helen Keller. I don't think there would be even a single one who haven't read this book. The students who are passed out from CBSE must have read, because ye novel mein syllabus hai. The Story of My Life by Helen Keller. So I invite Riya Garg to please turn on your video, unmute yourself. Riya Garg. I think she left.
Rashmi Sources सारी अपडेट्स पाने के लिए बेल आइकन दबाएं.
Okay, Riya is not with us, so let us invite our next participant, Mukesh Kumar. Mukesh Kumar. Who is going to give us a review over the movie Lagaan? Mukesh, please turn on your video.
I'm visible, audible, ma'am.
Yes, you are audible and visible both.
Hello everyone, I am Mukesh from MSc Environment Science from ECE department. Today I am going to movie review Lagaan. Lagaan is a Bollywood movie released in 2001, directed by Ashutosh Gowarikar, film star Aamir Khan, Rishi Singh, Susaini Malai and Rajesh Vivekan. Lagaan, which is literacy means tax. It is interesting and inspirational movie. Is a story of common people stabilized in 1893 during the time of British Raj. Chapakan is a small village of center of India. The film narrates the village determined to against the opposition and injustice. The story goes like some things. There has been no rain in the village for 8 years. Two are unable to pay rent to the capital residence. So top of that, they asked to double tax, but villagers were against it. Then after Captain Russell proposal of a cricket game to the villagers, if they will beat the British in the game, they will exempted from tax for 3 consecutive years. If they lose to pay 3 more times rent. So because villages life or death lesson in it. But Bhuvan H. Amir Khan played role in Young Farmer. He said there's an unfortunate job for save the villagers. He prepared the cricket team from his villagers and practices. Elizabeth was the sister of Captain Besser. She aspected and supported this battle. Game time came. The cricket game was for 3 days. Finally, villagers are won the game. They are calm. In this movie, art music are different from another movie. In this movie, many officers are British officer are played in role. We good men. The suit of Lagan is near about both in Gujarat. We got many inspiration from this movie as shown in this. How difficulties and challenges in front of us. We do not back. We find their rights and must struggle. Thank you, man.
Thank you so much. As you have given your review over the movie Lagan, इसका बहुत ही famous dialogue है, चूल्हे से रोटी निकालने के लिए चिमटे को अपना मुंह जलाए पड़ती. I have already mentioned that I am not good at mimicry, but I am trying. तो किसी भी चीज में हमने सक्सेसफुल होना है तो हमें हार्डवर्क करना ही पड़ेगा. इसका बेसिक मीनिंग मैं यही कंक्लूड कर सकती हूँ. एंड यू आर टू गुड. थैंक यू सो मच.
थैंक यू.
दिस टाइम आई हैव नो वर्ड्स टू लेट यू ऑल हैव इंट्रोडक्शन और अ हिंट बिकॉज द बुक चोजन बाय अनीशा इज एन ओशियन. यस, we don't have any words. According to me, no one could easily summarize the book chosen by Anisha, that is Srimad Bhagavad Gita. I welcome Anisha. Anisha, please turn your video on.
Am I audible and visible?
Yes, you are audible and visible.
Okay, thank you. No one who does a good work will ever come to a bad end, either here or in the world to come. A very good morning to all. My name is Anisha Garg, and today I will share my reviews on a book which I have read. But the book which inspires me the most, which introduced me to the ocean of knowledge, is the Bhagavad Gita. You may have seen many people who says that open any page of Bhagavad Gita and you will find answer to all your questions. Today, I will try to make you understand that how it actually works. Bhagavad Gita is a book which gives you the way to live. And it starts with the dilemmas of Arjun in the Kurukshetra. And Krishna becomes his mentor and guides him that he can do the right things. Similarly, every person has those dilemmas in life, like what to do or what not to do. So here it actually Bhagavad Gita starts. It begins with the dilemmas. It begins with the confusion. And Krishna guides Arjun and empowers him that he can do the right things. He is way more powerful than the people he is going to face in the battlefield. Similarly, every person have to understand that they are way more powerful than the situation they are facing right now and have the power to overcome them. Bhagavad Gita builds in you the sense of fortitude, strength, confidence, and empowers you that you can take the right decisions. We can learn many lessons from the Bhagavad Gita. But here I will talk about the text, which is from chapter number 2. It talks about the seasons, which are changing every year. But whether it's too hot or too cold, we never stop performing our duties, right? So it tells us that we should focus on the goals rather to just conclude that this is happening or that is happening. So this is what it wants to say. And the next text is my personal favorite. And I think you will be able to relate with it more easily. This text is from chapter number 6. It talks about the mind being a friend or enemy to you. If you befriend your mind, it will empower you. But if you don't deal it with rightly, it will be led to your downfall. we can take an example, like if you want to get up early in the morning and go for a jog, but when the alarm goes, what actually happens? Your mind will say you slept late last night. Take it easy, we'll do next time, and you will not wake up. But on the other hand, if you learn to train your mind using the proper intellectual and spiritual power, your mind will be the greatest asset and your friend. Now here I have only introduced like how you can take lessons from the Bhagavad Gita to solve any problems in the life. There is nothing in the life which you may not find in the Bhagavad Gita. And we should learn how we can learn the chapters from the Bhagavad Gita to solve any of the problem. And now I want to show it also. Here it is. So I will recommend that you should learn it. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Anisha. You were too good. The next participant along with us is Achint Sardana. He is going to have a review over the book Splendid Suns. A Thousand Splendid Suns. And the basic hint I can give you is the society has no chance of success if women is uneducated. That means...
Am I audible and visible?
Yes, you are audible and visible.
May I start?
Yes, you can.
Good morning, respected jury members and my dear friends. My name is Achint Sardana, and I'm going to review the book, A Thousand Splendid Suns. A Thousand Splendid Suns is a book written by Khaled Husseini, also the author of the book, The Kite Runner. The title, A Thousand Splendid Suns, means beauty and culture of Afghanistan. But the irony is, the book depicts about the atrocities like suppression of women and terrorism in the country of Afghanistan. It is a 384 pages book, but one doesn't feel bored while reading it. It revolves around two protagonists, Laila and Maryam. Maryam, a young girl who lost her mother at a young age and is married at the age of 15 years, and is married to a man who is 20 years older than her. Further sufferings and hardship faced by her in different city, a place where women are restricted to be at home, not allowed to talk freely within the society, and facing somber atmosphere. In the same city lives the second protagonist, Laila. Laila is a young girl who is provided education and utmost love by her father. But unfortunately, the family is deceased due to the terror attacks. At this point of time, these two characters meet. From being unknown to the wives of a common husband, these two characters share a bond of love and strong connection as the book goes through. I felt that this book is surely it has strong sense of love, which is expressed throughout the book. The strong connections, strong emotions, and intriguing characters have made this book a must read and a recommendable by me. All the book, at last I want to say that the book shows that the prejudice against the women and the terrorism should be prohibited, and peace, love, and gender equality should be promoted in any society we live. As these both characters displayed such a wonderful activity and wonderful love they have expressed, we should learn from them. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Achint. The next participant in the similar bid is Puneet. Puneet, please turn your video on. I think he's not present. So coming to the next is Shubham Rohila from B.Tech Computer Science, second year. Okay, she is also not present. Nitika Dhul, she is going to have a movie review over the bucket list. Nitika Di, please turn your video on. She is also not available. So the next participant is Sugandha Singh. Sugandha, turn your video on. She is going to deliver the movie review over Tare Zameen Par.
Can I start?
Yes, Sugandha, you can.
Good morning, honorable judges, hosts, and all the participants. I, Sugandha Singh, would like to present before you the lesson from the movie Tare Zameen Par. An award-winning Indian movie, Tare Zameen Par, narrates the story of an 8-year-old boy, Ishan, who is suffering from dyslexia. It's a rare condition in which victim feels difficulties learning despite normal intelligence. Unaware of his conditions, his parents portray this as an excuse for laziness. Later, Ram, an art teacher, becomes Ishan's tutor. Ram researches a lot about Ishan's condition. He then explains it to the class, inspiring his students. Even though the movie displays the child, the ideas are still applicable to everyone. At the same time of adversity, it is difficult to figure out the problem. This movie clearly characterizes the figure out the needs for personal development. Even more, the time you invest in yourself later result in fruitful conclusion. Lessons which I personally learned from this movie are: the first one, everyone is unique in their own way. One should not criticize children of their inability in studying the social school subjects. Following your interest will make our job more fruitful. All the parents want their children to become doctors, IAS, engineers. How many of us want our child to become a painter, a dancer? I think a very less. So break the notion of conventional ideas. Let your children do the unconventional. Third, not everyone can secure good marks. Torturing a kid may be disastrous. Don't ridicule your child. Restrict from ridiculing them in front of everyone. They lose self-confidence and they tend to go in a state of depression. Eventually, stricter the parents, more hideous and bigger liars the children become. You must try to maintain a healthy relationship with your young souls as they demand time and attention. Let your children pursue their passion and explore the world around. This will build their, in fact, boost their self-esteem. Anyone your best friend, disabled or able, kids are sweet, pure. A best mentor can change their life. And the last one, har bachche ki apni khubi hoti hai, apni kabiliyat hoti hai, apni chahat hoti hai. Thank you for listening.
A very big round of applause for her. Har bachche ki apni khubi hoti hai, apni kabiliyat hoti hai. Thank you so much, Sugandha. I must add that there is a lot of peer pressure on the children. No child can opt for their stream. No child can openly play. No child can openly watch TV. No child can frankly work over the mobile phones. Every time one start using mobile phone, mama or papa enter the room. Phone chala rahe ho? Padhai kar lo thodi der. Every time study, study, study or career. Nothing else. Someone comment me कि आप अपने अपने फेवर के लिए बोल रहे हो. नहीं, मैं अपने फेवर के लिए नहीं बोल रही हूँ, मैं आप सभी के फेवर के लिए बोल रही हूँ, ताकि आप अच्छे से कंफर्टेबली घर पे फोन चला पाए. थैंक यू सो मच सुगंधा. द नेक्स्ट पार्टिसिपेंट इज प्रीति. प्रीति फ्रॉम बीटेक सीएससी थर्ड ईयर.
Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible and visible both.
Okay. 29 medals in International Women Wrestling Championship and still practices on counting and on fire to make this number of medals more and more. Yes, you all are getting it right. I'm going to review the movie which describes the whole story and the deterministic story behind these unbelievable medals in wrestling championship. Yes, this movie name is Dangal. A very good morning to all of you present here. My name is Preeti and I'm the student of BTech CSE third year. I'm going to review the most record-breaking movie, Dangal. It was directed by the most talented director, Nitish Kumar. As you all know, he's the unbelievable director in the industry. So his movie is also the unbelievable and praiseable in the society. It gives the most deterministic and empowering messages to youth, society and to the country also. So movie starts with the dream of getting international gold medal in the wrestling championship. This story is truly based upon a father, Mahavir Singh Fogart, and his two daughters, Geeta and Babita. So they used to live in a Bilali village, and this village is located in district Bhiwani, state of Haryana. And after this, movie starts with the dream, as I told earlier. The dream was of Mahavir Singh Fogart, but he was not able to complete it due to some economic instability in his home and house. His father don't allow to make this happen, and he take his responsibility towards his family. After this, he was not give up on his dream, and he was hoping for a son to make this happen for him and for the country. But he gets four daughters back to back named Geeta, Babita, Ritu and Priyanka. And there was a time there Mahavir Singh Fogart gave up on his dream. He was thinking that nothing can happen which makes his dream complete. So the day come when he realized and sees the potential of his girls, Geeta and Babita, when they beat hardly two boys who won a little fight in children's. And after seeing the potential, Mahavir Singh Fogart decided to make them wrestle championship and make them prepare to earn the international gold medal for the country. But there was lot of hurdle which came into their ways. And after seeing all the ups and downs in relationship of father and daughter, the Geeta and Babita make this happened to the country. And in 2012, Geeta was the first woman to qualify, the first woman wrestler to qualify for the Olympics. And in 2010 Commonwealth Games, she got the international gold medal and makes our country pride. After this, following Geeta was also following him. And 2012, she also got the gold. And there is no words to appreciate him because their efforts was not appreciated by the society in that time. And Mahavir Singh Phogat has lit a flame of wrestling championship in the country, and nowadays we can see all the results of his efforts. And yes, all I say that this movie has the very potential messages to the society and youth and all the children who wants to get success in their life, and it's feel the energetic potential to anyone who see this movie, and it is most understandable and relatable to me and of course to everyone in India. And yes, it makes very pride to other countries, so for example in China. Okay, thank you so much for listening me.
थैंक यू सो मच थ्री मिनट एंड 30 seconds ओके थैंक यू सो मच एज शी वॉज टॉकिंग अबाउट दंगल सो मेनी डायलॉग्स फ्रॉम द मूवी वर स्ट्राइकिंग इन माई माइंड जैसे मेडलिस्ट पेड़ पर नहीं लगते उन्हें बनाना पड़ता है और हिज डैड आस्क द डॉटर अगर सिल्वर लाएगी तो आज नहीं तो कल तुझे भूल जाएंगे लेकिन अगर गोल्ड लाएगी तो तेरी मिसाल दी जाएगी क्योंकि मिसालें भूली नहीं जाती मिसालें दी जाती हैं एंड आई वुड डेफिनेटली लाइक टू टेल आर जजेस दैट आर ट्रेनिंग एंड प्लेसमेंट सेल डायरेक्टर प्रताप सर ऑल्सो यूज टू से मारी छोरियां छोरों से कम है के एंड इट डेफिनेटली मोटिवेट ऑल द गर्ल्स द नेक्स्ट पार्टिसिपेंट विद अस इज Akash from BTEC Packaging. Akash. Akash, unmute yourself.
Yes, I did.
Yes, you are audible and visible. Please continue.
Hello, everyone. This is Akash here, and today I'm gonna tell you about the movie, the half of it, and. That was very awesome. I mean, say if we talk about in a youngster language, that was lit, awesome. I mean to say, and which is directed by Ali Chu, the famous Hollywood director, and I like their movies too much, and I have seen many movies, and now I'm gonna tell you about the movie, the half of it, which is. Directed and written by Ali Chu and released on the date of May 1st, 2020. And May 1st, 2020. And the best part of this movie and the best thing about this movie won Best Narrative Feature Award at 2020 Tribeca Film Festival, and there are three main characters in the movie, which is only entire focus on them, and the two one is girl and a boy, and last one is also girl, and girl name is Ali Chu, and the boy. Paul Munsky, and the third one is Esther Flores. And Esther Flores and Ali Chu is a very, Asian American student in America. And other one is they already stayed there and and Ali Chu is very introvert. And a very shy type girl, And in, you know, in the foreign schools, teachers give assignment to their students like essay writing and many things. So Ali Chu helped to the entire class to written essay, but not free. Not free. They she took money from them to write a letter by him, by her. And Paul Manske have a crush on Esther Flores, so he decided to give a love letter to Esther Flores, but he don't know how to write a letter and you know, love letter type. So he decided to wrote by Ali Chu. So he decided, and then he convinced her to write letters.
Your time is over. Thank you so much, Akash.
Thank you. Okay. Thank you so much.
So the next participant with us is Parkhi. Parkhi from MBA department. She is going to deliver the movie review over The Sky is Pink. Yes, The Sky is Pink, donating the symbol of love and affection. So Parkhi, please turn your video on, unmute yourself.
Good morning, everyone. I hope you all are safe and healthy. And I am Parthi. I am going to share my views, my opinions about the best film being made in the Bollywood recently. That is, The Sky is Pink. This movie is made by Sonali Bose, made this piece of art which drives its audience in an emotional roller coaster. When I say emotional, you must be, the first thing came to your mind must be crying. But no, this movie has everything. Love, passion, romance, kindness, and everything. This movie is based on a true life story of a couple who lost their child to a rare disease. And And the teenager who lost his life to a rare disease, both is shown courageous and fearless to death, which we are about facing that, which we all are most afraid of. She has also narrated how her family has gone through, has shown sacrifice and care, how her parents begged for her life. And how her parents decided to live separately for 10 years so that she could live. This is an amazing movie. I would recommend you all to see. In this, Priyanka Chopra has given an exceptional performance as a mother. And her great, with her great gestures, she ensures that her daughter's remaining life. Her daughter's remaining life is packed with happiness. And Farhan Akhtar has also shown an exemplary performance as a lover and as a father too. Together they made a very hard choice of letting her daughter go and choosing quality of life over quantity of life for her. This is a beautiful, beautiful, heart-touching, and daring, and yet full of life story. In this, we are shown that how we can. It teaches us how we can face the toughest situations in life with a smile of courage. And this also stands on the proverb that when world gives you thousands of reasons to cry, you show them that you have millions of reasons to smile on. So I would like to conclude by saying that this pandemic must be giving you hard time, but if we stand together and be aware, we can pass this on. Thank you.
Thank you so much. So the next participant with us is Priyanka. Priyanka, please turn on your video.
Am I audible? Hello?
Yes, Priyanka, you are audible and visible.
Okay. Good morning, all of you. I am Priyanka. My movie, I think everybody has seen, English, released in 2012. It is a very great movie, especially for us, because almost all of us are not well spoken or not very qualified, not that much comfortable with speaking in English. Because everyone has spoken with her parents or with family members, literally in Hindi. Because our mother tongue also is Hindi, we are more comfortable in speaking in Hindi. So my movie, that's why I chose it, is English, because here Sridevi, the main lead of this movie, is a simple, humble, quiet nature, and soft-spoken housewife. She is playing a role of housewife who is well educated, no doubt, but she's not comfortable with English. She can't speak that much frequently English. Her daughter and her husband are very good, or we can say they can speak very frequently English. So they every day in their life, they start mocking her mother and her wife, that is Sridevi, because they feel embarrassing when she speaks with someone in Hindi in front of them, because they start they think that English speaking is a set a standard of life, because nowadays or in our daily life also, we see that everyone who speaks English, we think that he is speaking English, he is well educated, he has some standard, that thinking, you know, everyone minds them. She, in this movie, she is not that much frequently speak English, but she overcome her fear, overcome that hurdle. She faced that difficulty and try again and again to learn English. See, in this movie, she has opportunity to go New York, Manhattan, to her sister's house. There he stay a board of English learning. So after she said, okay, I'm here for 4 weeks, I can start English speaking. So she tried harder and harder, and get over her weakness. So in my point of view, everyone has some weaknesses, but if we try hard, we can overcome every weakness. So please, everyone, try hard. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Priyanka. There was a scene in the movie that always strike in our mind when we listen to English. Shashi was asked, how are you gonna manage in our country if you don't know English? And the reply comes like, you are managing in our country without knowing Hindi. Her that spirit was worth appreciating. And now I would like to invite the next participant, S. Ganeshwar. Please turn your video on. You are requested to turn your video on.
Hello. My voice is audible?
Yes, you are audible. Please turn your video on.
My video is not playing. My voice is muted, unmuted, but my video is not getting unmuted.
You are now audible.
My voice is audible, but my video is not coming.
So let him go with the voice only.
Okay, better luck next time.
No, Nitya, let him go. Let him go with audio only.
Okay, sir.
Can I start?
Yes, you can.
So, good afternoon, sir. I am here to say about a movie review called Ae Jawani Ae Diwani. So, way back exactly 7 years ago, this movie has lived in the Indian cinema industry, winning the hearts of so many million people. Being an absolute blockbuster, this was resides in the hearts of million people over there. This movie has taught me from disputing lives to choice, friendship to career. This movie is complete blend of romance, thrill, and mostly importantly, passion. The things that I learned in this is some friendships are forever. Sometimes people who love the most doesn't love you back. But it's okay, life moves on and you find someone worth you love. Traveling makes you fall in love with yourself and with life. Don't get so attached or so involved in making your career so that you forget to live present. Sometimes in life, you have to give up on some dreams so that the things actually matters, even the highest sacrifice are worth it. And in this movie, I really inspired by one dialogue, and that is Zindagi mein Zindagi jitna bhi try karo, Zindagi mein kuch na kuch to chhoot jata hai. Jisliye ya kidhar hai wahi se santusht ho. And it means instead of crabbing over things and running behind everything that you not process, it's better to be with happy what they are. And instead of thinking about past or future, we should live our present. And this thing I want to say, that people are so busy that they are thinking about future and not living the present. So this thing I want to say in this. And moreover, till now, when I see this movie, I will see with the same zeal and same excitement. This is the movie which all must be watch, and they must. And this is the movie maybe it change your life also. And for me, it's just not a movie, it's an emotion. A part of me which always cherishes when I see this movie. This movie is completely based on our basic life and today's generation also. And that's it. And this was written by an Aziz Dalal and screenplay by an Ayan Majdar. That's it, I want to say. Thank you.
Apurva, are you here? Apurva, are you here? Okay. Sunitya.
Yes, Nitya. Yes, now. One more participant is left, Rahul. Rahul, you are requested to please turn on your video, unmute yourself. M27, Rahul. Rahul, you are not audible.
Am I audible clearly?
Yes, you are audible and visible both.
Hello.
which is the well-intentioned movie that will give you ample opportunity to wipe tears. Good morning, everyone. I am Rahul from ECE first year. We began dreaming with the help of a teacher. Most of the times they were people and sometimes they were situations. Those who taught us are clear screening and take defeat in our stride. We became the person we are today because we learned our lesson. Those who taught us might not be perfect in themselves, but they are good enough for us. Hitchki is about such a person who is determined to give innovative knowledge and understanding to the world. Nana Mathur suffers from the neurological condition called tantrum syndrome since childhood. We are told it's a speech defect that aggravates when she gets nervous. She wants to teach because years ago a teacher stood up for her and she could understand the impact. She could have it. She decided to stood up in the world and did the same. After 5 years of 18 unsuccessful attempts, one of the Mumbai's prestigious schools gives her a chance to teach. The teenagers she is supposed to teach are unruly and live in a bad neighborhood. She's from a bad neighborhood and feel enlightened among the students who are from other social strata. But Nana is supposed to teach her a social purpose. Hitchki begins with the big oscillate between the Nana's life, who she is battling with the family and other of it. Hitchki is a well-intentioned movie and definitely move you. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Rahul. I would request judges to please add his name, as his name was not in the list. Rahul Saini.
So his number is M27 or anything else?
M27, sir.
Okay, so Akash, name of Akash should be replaced with this Rahul. Because at M27, I think Akash is there, na?
Judges. No, sir, there were only 26 students.
M27 is Akash, and Akash is already has spoken before that. So yes. I think we should give some other
number. Yeah, we should give him M29. Please give him M29.
Yes. There were two students. Their name were repeated, sir. Shubham and Aman. Their name are repeated.
No, that's okay. But now we should use M29 for this.
Yes, sir.
Now I request Reena ma'am to please guide the contestants.
First of all, thank you Pratap Singh sir and all the college staff to provide me an opportunity. And students, you have done very, very well. Like doing nothing is better than doing something. So who have participated in this event, I must appreciate their courage so that they were able to at least speak something. Hena? So many of the students may not have taken participation because some hesitation or maybe some of other reason. So who have taken this courage, I must appreciate and always wish for all of you that move on in life, and whatever opportunity you will get, you just get it. Because opportunity life mein baar baar nahi aata, lekin jab aata hai, to usko chhodna nahi hai. So एक मेरा बुक जैसे सर ने बताया कि पब्लिश हुआ था, आप सभी स्टूडेंट्स के लिए आई थिंक कि मोस्ट एप्रोप्रिएट जो मुझे लगा एक पोयम, वो मैं आप सबके साथ शेयर करना चाहूंगी अगर सर परमिशन देते हैं।
श्योर मैम, श्योर।
या तो पोयम का, ये मेरा बुक पब्लिश हुआ था, मन में उठती उमंगे तरंगे, एंड इनॉग्रेटेड बाय एक्टर यशपाल शर्मा। तो इसमें एक टॉपिक है लगन। सो आजकल स्टूडेंट्स सब कोशिश करते हैं कि हम मतलब कुछ अलग से करें या फिर किसी ना किसी वजह को रीजन मानते हैं कि हम नहीं कर पा रहे हैं, एक्स वाई जी रीजन, हमारा फैमिली बैकग्राउंड नहीं है, मेरे में ये वीकनेस है। तो हम इन चीजों को साइड में रख के अगर हम खुद से बात करते हैं कि वो जो भी हम चाहते हैं वो सब हमारे ही अंदर है, we have to just discover and work on that. So एक लगन ऐसी चीज है जो किसी भी अगर स्टूडेंट में है या किसी भी व्यक्ति के अंदर है, तो वो भी जो भी सोचता है, like it's all about the thought process, he or she can achieve that. So मैं शुरू करती हूँ समय कम लेते हुए। लगन है तो झेल जाओगे पीड़ा, लगन है तो झेल जाओगे पीड़ा, लगन है तो सही अर्थों में रह पाओगे, उठा पाओगे बेड़ा, लगन है तो झेल जाओगे पीड़ा, लगन है तो अहम होगा दूर, लगन है तो अहम होगा दूर, लगन है तो बेअसर होंगे कड़वे बोल, लगन है तो बेअसर होंगे कड़वे बोल, लगन है तो मार्ग के पत्थर भी लगेंगे फूल, लगन है तो मार्ग के पत्थर भी लगेंगे फूल, लगन है तो रौनक चेहरे की न हटा सकेगी धूल, लगन है तो रौनक चेहरे की न हटा सकेगी धूल, लगन है तो प्यार होगा लोगों से, लगन है तो प्यार होगा लोगों से, लगन है तो उत्साह हो गया कार्य करने में, लगन है तो उड़ना चाहोगे हर पल, लगन है तो उड़ना चाहोगे हर पल, लगन है तो जाओगे बुरी लतों से, हो जाओगे बुरी लतों से स्वतंत्र, लगन है तो जी जान लगाओगे लक्ष्य प्राप्ति पर। बहुत ध्यान देने वाली बात है ये, लगन है तो जी जान लगाओगे लक्ष्य प्राप्ति पर, लगन है तो कार्य करोगे अपना ध्यान केंद्रित कर, लगन है तो गिरोगे भी, लगन है तो गिरोगे भी, लेकिन लगन है तो गिरकर उठोगे भी, लगन है तो झेल जाओगे पीड़ा, लगन है तो सही अर्थों में जिंदा रह पाओगे, उठा पाओगे बेड़ा। तो लगन एक ऐसी चीज है जो हमें कभी नहीं छोड़नी है और हमें अपने अंदर से ही सारे आंसर मिल जाएंगे। सो विद दिस नोट आई जस्ट थैंक टू ऑल ऑफ यू अगेन, थैंक यू वेरी मच।
थैंक यू सो मच मैम। Now I would request Sanjay sir to please unmute yourself and guide our contestants.
Sanjay Singh ji, can kindly make your video on and unmute yourself.
Yes, Sanjay is coming. Sanjay ji, unmute kar lijiye.
जी हो, हेलो, आर यू गेटिंग मी सर।
हाँ जी, आ रही आवाज आ रही
है। वैसे हाँ जी, बताएं सर।
जी हाँ
Sanjay, you have been requested by the anchor to say some words.
Sanjay ji, unmute yourself.
कर दिया सर मैंने
अब ठीक है
हाँ जी सर
सो यू आर रिक्वेस्टेड टू से अ फ्यू वर्ड्स अबाउट दिस प्रोग्राम और व्हाट यू लाइक अबाउट दिस प्रोग्राम
सजेशंस फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स
ओह इट वाज अ वंडरफुल प्रोग्राम यस 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 लेट मी थैंक फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल टू ऑल ऑफ यू who made it possible and gave me an opportunity to interact with the young boys and the girls who are full of energy and utilizing their time in this such a pandemic time the world is facing and a lot of mental stress nowadays also. So the activities like WVS6 engages the youth mentally and productively. So interacting with you all is really a matter of satisfaction and gives a lot of satisfaction at heart and mental level. So, with the mindset that just to judge the students on different parameters, but you have made my day wonderful with a lot of presentation. So, congratulations to all. And all are winners, so no losers. So I want to make two points because today we are focusing on book review and on film review. Are you getting me, sir? Hello.
Yes, yes, yes. Go ahead.
Are you getting me? Okay. Are you getting me, sir? Hello.
Sanjay ji, please carry on.
Hello. मैं ये बताना चाहता था कि because today we are focusing two things, book and film review. मैं चीज बताना चाहता हूँ बहुत से बच्चों ने मैं critically evaluate कर दूँ just simple कर लूँ इसको.
जैसा आपको ठीक लगे.
Hello. हाँ सभी बच्चों ने बहुत अच्छा प्रेजेंटेशन दिया बट यस आई वांट टू मेक वन थिंग इज बुक रिव्यू जो होता है दैट इज अ क्रिटिकल अबाउट द टेक्स्ट द इवेंट लिटरेचर के ऊपर
आई थिंक देयर इज सम इंटरनेट कनेक्शन प्रॉब्लम विद द संजय सर
So, book review जो होता है make an argument and most of the important element in review is it is a commentary not a summary. Majority of the students have not named कि who's the publisher of the author उसके उसके character कौन थे agree book author उसमें judgments क्या थी तो रिव्यू के अंदर जजमेंट अपनी ओपिनियन देना भी बहुत जरूरी होता है व्हिच आई थिंक बहुत बच्चों ने सिंपली यस और नो और गुड के बारे में बात किया नेक्स्ट थिंग इज कि बुक रिव्यू जब भी करें उसको डेफिनेटली यू आर नॉट दैट ग्रेट मैन जिस आदमी किताब लिखी है
Sanjay ji, there is some problem regarding connectivity at your end.
Exactly, मेरे को मतलब अब आगे ये बीच में drop हो रहा है कई बार. Okay, मैं brief ही रखता हूँ. Yeah, brief. Book reviews जो होते हैं बच्चों, ये मतलब इसके अंदर आपको हुज अ पब्लिशर हुज ऑथर जस्टिफिकेशन ऑफ द टाइटल आपको जो बुक का होता है वो आपको बताना होता है इसमें आपको समराइज करना होता है हाउ द करेक्टर है हाँ जी आवाज आ रही है सर आर यू गेटिंग मी सर हाँ जी मैं ब्रीफ करता हूँ नहीं तो इंटरनेट से थोड़ा नाराज है लगता है सो इसलिए ये रिव्यू को एडजस्टमेंट हो एनालाइज द वर्क कि और भी किसी ने किया तो उसके बाद
Okay, sir.
Invite next judge, and I think the crux of what Sanjay ji wants presenting our book or movie review. This is the main conclusion which Sanjay ji wants to communicate.
सर मैं एक चीज लास्ट में कहना चाहूंगा जो बच्चों ने बहुत मिस किया खासतौर से रिव्यू के बारे में आपने उसके दो बच्चों ने सिर्फ डायरेक्टर का नाम बताया प्रोड्यूसर करेक्ट और उसकी टेक्निकलिटीज भी बतानी होती है फिल्म रिव्यूज के अंदर वो कहीं मिस था लेकिन ये मौका अच्छा था आज बहाना बनेगा ये कि बच्चे और इसको सीख सकें बट अदरवाइज इज अ फैंटास्टिक शो एंड मोर ओवर द प्लेटफॉर्म जो आपने मौका दिया सभी बच्चों को इस्तेमाल करने का आप भी और लगातार डेली बेसिस के ऊपर आप तो वेबिनार कर रहे हैं सो आप भी बहुत एनर्जी इसमें पुट इन कर रहे हैं तो इस बातों का ध्यान रखेंगे तो मेरे ख्याल से और फिल्म रिव्यूज पढ़ेंगे और ज्यादा और बुक रिव्यूज पढ़ेंगे तो डेफिनेटली ये आसान काम नहीं होता बुक रिव्यू करना और किसी फिल्म को रिव्यू करना क्योंकि आप भी मास्टर बन जाते हैं रिव्यू करने के बाद तो ये बहुत अच्छा प्रयास था स्टूडेंट्स का सो आई वांट टू कांग्रेचुलेट टू एवरीवन एंड स्पेशली टू यू दोज हु हैव मेड द थिंग्स पॉसिबल एंड टू माय को जज आल्सो बधु बैठी हुई हैं उन्होंने भी पूरा टाइम दिया इसके अंदर
Thank you so much, sir. Now I request Nisha ma'am. Nisha ma'am, please guide our contestants.
Okay, thank you, Riya. I must say I was very impressed with the quality of the contents that the students get. And I congratulate to all are the winners. Main thing is the participation. If you participate in an event, that is the big thing. So all are the winners. So don't be sad that you are not a winner or you can't go for that. So you all are the winners. And the second thing, what the books and the movies that the topic, the review of the movies and books. The main thing is that everyone watching the movies and reading the books. But for the entertainment or for getting some or for seeking to get something, it depends upon the view. How we look over all these things. So being like sir say ki Sanjay sir say ki you must just miss some things, but you must be an expert. It's not possible because every expert is a beginner, is a starter. So it's a starting point for you that maybe sometime you get every knowledge and the next time you be have the everything that discussed over here. So first I want to say for an expert, you must have to choose what do you want to do, not that what others are doing. So select that one in your perfect. Yes, you can do this. Not go for the others what they are doing. I have to copy them and I do that one. So be your own. And I really congratulate to all. That's a very nice session. And thank you, Pratap ji, and the organizers for inviting me as a judge here. Thank you so very much.
Thank you so much, ma'am. And the next gem with us is Dr. Vivek. Please, sir, turn on your video and guide our contestants.
Yes, it was very, very, very good effort by our students. It's very difficult really to comment upon someone's work who has put in so much of effort, 3, 4, 5 years, and you just has to criticize him or to give some positive feedback. I think Madam Reena Yadav, she must be understanding this better, as she has also written a book. So, but it was very good effort by all the students. I listened to 10 students and they have done very well. And participation is the main motto. So, and first, second, third position. So we had to decide somewhere, but the contest was very close and all the participants, they did very well. And on TPC, I would like to tell that for so many days I am observing in the university during this lockdown period, TPC is very, very much active. They have made all the students in working mode. They are launching daily new contests, and all the students, they are really participating in these. Those students who want to do something, they want to use their holidays, like situation is there, so they want to use their holidays, they want to do something, they are coming into this TPC activities, and I congratulate Dr. Pratap Malikji that you have really made TPC an active element in GJU. And anchoring was also very nice. Both the girls, they anchored very well. They were in full command, and in this era of new technology, it is definitely new to us because we are going to use this technology these days only. So you all handled it very well. There was no any doubt anywhere. So you handled it with full command. So very good efforts by all the hosts and students. And there was also nice, very nice poem by Madam Reena Yadav. So she told us good book. So I will definitely go for that. And once again, I thank you all, especially Training and Placement Cell of GJU and the students who participated in this event for making this event a success. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. I request Pratap sir to please announce the results.
So thank you once again, Nitya. So again, I express my thanks to all the judges who have used this online platform to make their judgment, and they have prepared the result very fastly and very efficiently. So in main room, there were 15 students, and in that section, Madam Reena ji and Sanjay Singh ji were the judges. So out of those 15 students, almost all the students have got almost equal marks with a difference of 10 to 20 marks. But again, we have to announce first three toppers. So third position goes to Sugandha Singh. So please give a big hand, please clap, please applaud Sugandha Singh at third position. Second position goes to Parkhi Bansal. And I request the contestant also to make the video on so that all may see his or her face. Parkhi Bansal, please make, Sugandha, congratulations.
Thank you.
Parkhi Bansal.
We can unmute actually for clapping.
Okay.
Yeah, virtual clapping can be done.
yeah, we can do virtual clapping. We are also having option of this reactions in Zoom.
Yes.
Through that also we can do clapping. And first position goes to Achint Sardana. So big round of applause for Achin. Achin, please make your video on. Achin Sardana. Yeah, he has made. Yes. Yes, Achin, congratulations.
Congratulations.
Okay. And in second section in that breakout room, where competition was more tougher because all winners were there in that room. So third position goes to Nishit Shubhankar. Nishit Shubhankar, please make your video on. Big round of applause for Nishit. Nishit, congratulations once again.
Thank you, sir.
Volunteers are requested to make the audio on of the student who comes on the dais. Okay, so second position goes to Radhika Singhal. Radhika Singhal, please make your video on. Big round of applause for Radhika. Yes, Radhika has come. Congratulations, Radhika. Okay. And first position goes to Ankita Jaglan. Congratulations to all the winners. Thank you.
Congratulations, Radhika. Congratulations, Nishit.
Nitya, over to you.
Congratulations to all the winners. Now, I would like all the volunteers and winners to make their video on so that we can have a picture together.
Yeah, this is a digital method of group photo. Yes, all volunteers as well as winners, they have to make their video on. Judges also, chief guest sir also. Okay, so I think all have come. Only winners. ठीक है, थैंक यू.
Now I request Aditya sir for Thanksgiving.
Once again, Professor Vinod Kumarji, Librarian, Rural Ambition Institute of Science and Technology, Hisar, and Ms. Reema Yadav, General Manager, Sales and Marketing from SciComm Course Flexio Print Private Limited Delhi, Mr. Sanjay Singh, Training Placement Officer, GJU SNT Hisar, Dr. Vivek Gupta Ji, Assistant Professor, Department of Physics, and Dr. Nisha Ji, Administrative Business Incubator Manager, Haryana Agriculture University, Hisar, our Director, Shri Pratap Singh Malik, Training Placement Cell, volunteers, and all the students. It's my privilege to be asked to propose the word of thanks on this weekly virtual speakathon session 6, which was a book and a movie review. And what I have seen, the students have given their best, and I think I also got some ideas of like which book I have to go for now and which movies I can watch, because I think I have not seen a lot of movies which has been reviewed by the students, so I must go for that. And I hope my students also have got the idea to what kind of book and what kind of movie they have to watch during their leisure time. And I would like to thank all the judges and our chief guests to give us their precious time to judge our students and to come to this virtual meeting. So thank you all the judges and our chief guests. I would like to thank our director, Shri Pratap Singh Malik, for guiding us and doing these kind of programs for the students, because these kind of programs uplift our students, not only on the basis of communication skills, but also these kind of programs remove the hesitation to face the world. So this is a very good opportunity given by our placement cell director. I would like to thank volunteers, Nitya, Deekshu, Pratibha, Devanshi, Sachin, Muskan, Apoorva, Inderjeet, Lisa, Brijesh, Prince, Rohit, for making this program a success, because of them only we could do such a great program. So I would like to, in the end, I would like to thank all the contestants for participating in this program. And I will request other contestants to please share your views about this program to other friends so that more number of participants can join in the next program. Thank you all. Thank you very much.